Work of the great Dr. Sigmund Freud centered the attention of the whole scientific world on the subject of dreams. It is not surprising, therefore, that one of Freud's fellow psychologists, Dr. Ignaz Jezauers, should have made a hobby of collecting and recording strange dreams which were imparted to him during his years of practice in old Vienna. What is surprising, however, is that in the doctor's collection, there is at least one dream which no psychiatric theory can account for. A dream that defies the very premises of Freudianism itself.
The rain fell steadily on the streets of Amsterdam. Hendrik van der Moon, a member of the Amsterdam police force, drew the collar of his coat around his neck and shuddered as he lingered at the canal bridge, fascinated by the ripple of the raindrops in the water below him.
Mein Gott! A man! In the water! And he is found and gagged!
Early the following morning, in the little town of Lockel, Switzerland, one Gustav Mertz, who was both the police chief of Lockel and also its police force, read a telegram in the privacy of his office.
Identified him as Jacob Dauer, a watchmaker of your village. Was still alive when rescued from the Amsterdam Canal, but had been bound and gagged and severely beaten. Died without regaining consciousness. Obviously a victim of murder.
Later that morning, young Rudolf Bauer, son of the late Jakob Bauer, received a call from Police Chief Gustav Mertz.
My father? Dead?
Murdered, Rudolf. He went to Amsterdam on business, I suppose.
Yes. To buy materials.
He had enemies there?
Why, no. He scarcely knew anyone in Amsterdam.
And here in Lockel?
Well, no. Unless you would call Ulrich Tobler an enemy. He owed father a good deal of money. He refused to pay him. It made father very angry. At least it used to. A few weeks ago, father stopped talking about it. It was almost as if, well, as if for some reason, he was afraid of Ulrich Tobler.
It was not until 2 days later, when he was going through the deceased's personal papers, that Gustav Mertz found out why the watchmaker had grown afraid of his neighbor Ulrich Tobler. That was when he found the record of the dream. It was carefully written down in Jakob Bauer's neat, sturdy hand.
If I had had this dream only once, I would not bother to set it down. But it has come to me not once, nor twice,
nor even three times. Four times in all I have had it. In the dream, I was arguing with Ulrich Tobler. I reminded him of the money he owed me, and I told him he must pay. But he refused and laughed at me. And then I grew very angry, and I said I would sue him. A very evil look came into his eyes, and he turned away. I, too, turned away. And then, before I could take a step, something struck me on the back of the head. I fell to the ground, and the next thing I knew, I could see myself, bound and gagged and bleeding. Around me, there was nothing but a cold, wet blackness, for I had been thrown unconscious into the waters of a canal.
Yes, this was the dream that Jakob Bauer had written down a few days before he died. Can such a dream be classified, in the Freudian manner, as the mere expression of a subconscious fear or desire? Must it not rather be accepted as a prophecy incredible but true?